We can take questions.
I want to congratulate the Big Ten for doing a great job getting this tournament off and running. The conference office has done a great job all year long with all the, you know, protocol that they've put in to enable us to play. You know, Indiana's really good. A ton of respect for the program. They played really well. I really, you know, thought that they came out and really took it to us. And, you know, we stayed the course. I'm proud of our guys. We really passed the ball. We out-rebounded them and, you know, made some plays down the stretch. But they're really good. And Trace Jackson Davis is a problem. But we got a, you know, double-double from Ron and Miles. You know, Gio, 7 assists, 1 turnover. Jacob Young, you know, does a little bit of everything, you know, for us on the floor. Paul Mulcahy, how about those big threes that he hit? Caleb McConnell always gives us everything. Cliff was outstanding. His 10 minutes were really good. Montez was in foul trouble, but I thought everyone did a great job. And to hold the team to 18 points is a really good defensive effort.
Steve, as a head coach, how much better is it for you to see a balanced win like this where every guy is basically pulling the same amount of weight? It's got to be encouraging for you.
Yeah, I mean, real encouraging. I mean, 4 guys in double figures, but I just love the fact that, you know, we rebounded and, you know, they have good players. And I thought, you know, we did a good job. I know we had 19 and 9, but I thought in the second half we really did a good job, you know, making some adjustments to Davis and their screen coverages. You know, my assistants did a really good job, Brandon, Carl, and Steve Hain with the prep, you know, for this game. So the tip of the hat. But, you know, everyone chipped in and we had fun out there. And that's what I wanted our guys to do, play our defense, have fun. And they did that. And we don't have a lot of time. So we got a huge task tomorrow. So we got to get them off their feet as quickly as we can. And we got to get prepared for the next huge obstacle.
Steve, you guys were down 10 there early. You made a comeback. What do you think was biggest key to that turnaround during that point?
Yeah, I just think we settled down. You know, like I told our guys, you know, we were, you know, missing some open shots, turning the ball over a little bit. We settled down. We started really sharing the ball. And, you know, we were down before against them. So reminded them of that and just kept playing. Just kept playing.
We'll go to Keith Sargent and then Booth back.
Steve, the 2 3-pointers by Mulcahy, you touched on those, but you know, how much of a jolt did that give your team? How much of a lift?
Huge. And, you know, he got open looks, and I'm glad he kept taking them. He hit those two, and Jacob Young made some really good plays, too. So, you know, you get tip of the hat to, you know, it's half the assist, and Paul teed it up, and Paul, you know, played hard, and like he always does, and does a lot of things for us. So, you know, just timely shots. Miles with the timely rebound and put back, a couple of big plays down the stretch. Ron, then we made big free throws. So, again, everyone, great team win. And you need everybody at this time of the year. And when you're playing really good teams that are fighting like Indiana did today, you know, you need everyone.
Steve, Indiana was 2 for 16 from 3. Your defense held them to no field goals for basically the last 10 minutes. What about your defense overall in this game, and how proud are you of that, of the way they responded in that regard?
I mean, you know, just, you know, really proud. I mean, and they got us early. And then once we settled in and we were where we needed to be and guys were connected on that end of the floor, and, you know, Miles is taking up his space in the lane. Ron is rebounding. You know, when Ron gets a double-double, we're hard to beat when he rebounds like that too. So, you know, real pleased. I mean, we talk about it. They know, and they know what I want from them. And when they're locked in on that end of the floor, I mean, we held them at 5 points, I think. You know, terrific defensive effort.
Can you be loosey-goosey as you go into this game tomorrow? We know how hard this team is. We know how good they are. But, you know, do you want your club to play with the confidence and just the way they've been playing when they're playing at their best?
My group is confident. We never have an issue there. Yeah, so, again, every team in this league is really good. And, you know, Illinois, obviously, is playing great basketball. Much respect, you know, for their program. you know, but you play teams like that in this league. So everyone's pretty good, and we're going to have to play really well, and we're going to have to do a lot of things well to slow them down.
We'll go over to Shannon Ryan next.
Yeah, I was curious about that, just the pace of what you're expecting against Illinois and that being such a high-scoring game and to win last year with that. What is the key to trying to slow them down? And then if you don't mind, also, just did that win give you guys confidence at points this year, even when, you know, the losses were coming?
Yeah, I mean, I think we're like everybody in this league. You know, everyone went through a stretch. You know, we had one. But this team's always been confident. We've never had a confidence issue. We had some defensive issues and some offensive issues, but confidence, no, they're confident, you know. So, and you got to be. And these guys have been through a lot. The last 2 years has been a lot of games and a lot of tough finishes and all those things. But, you know, we'll worry you, you know, tonight about Illinois. Obviously, our guys have a tremendous amount of respect for them. So, I have a little time to prepare.
Yeah, I was just curious, if you're expecting, what the key would be to slowing them down when the last game was such a high-scoring, fast-paced game.
Well, I mean, they have a lot of answers, so it's hard to just pick one thing. I mean, Kofi in the paint, Io, you know, doing what he does. I mean, they have really good players, Trent Frazier. I mean, you got to take away everything. You got to play really good basketball. You got to execute. You got to not turn the ball over. You know, you got to do a lot of things well. You know, to be able to beat them. So it's not just one thing. When you play these good teams in this league, you know, the Michigans and the Illinois, and you got to do a lot of things well. So it'll be multiple efforts. Everyone's got to be ready to chip in, and, you know, you got to do it on both ends of the floor.
We'll go over next to Aaron Brightman and then Richie Schneider, right?
Hey, Coach. Just talking about the spirit of postseason play, guys playing with injuries. You know, Mulcahy's been battling a lot and to come through tonight. And then also on the flip side with Indiana, you know, Race Thompson and Ramon Franklin playing hurt, combined for 50 minutes. Just what this does, you know, in terms of the spirit of postseason play on both sides and how it brings the best out of guys.
Yeah, I mean, you know, everyone knows, you know, you're 40 minutes away from shutting it down and having your season end. So it's a different flavor. Really love the environment here today. I know it was a pro, obviously, Indiana crowd, but just to have people in the stands get us a little bit closer to what it used to be like. But, you know, like I tell my guys all the time, this isn't the time to be sore. This isn't the time, you know. They've battled a lot through the year, and Indiana's had their issues with injuries, and it's a hard thing to deal with all season long when you got guys that you're counting on, you know, that can't play. And, you know, thankful that Paul plays through it, but all our guys are a little bit banged up at this time of the year, and, you know, this isn't the time you can rest after.
Hey, Steve, so you touched on it a little bit before, but what do you think of Jacob Young's performance? He played almost every minute tonight, and he had the highest plus minus on the team.
Yeah, I mean, Jacob was completely, you know, locked in, you know, and he can cause a lot of problems. He really does. And he's got a great spirit and energy, and, you know, he can really defend and causes some havoc. And then he can get it going, too, on the offensive end. But love how he's been playing. He's a real competitor. I think he's one of the best defensive guards in the conference. You know, I think Miles, too, you saw his defensive presence. But I liked everyone else, you know, really stepped up. I mean, Caleb gives us great minutes on that, and Paul with some of his rotations. Gio did a good job, too, and how he shared the game tonight, seven assists, one turnover, really calmed us down at times when we needed it. And, you know, he's always ready to take that big shot.
I'm going to take two more questions for Coach, and then we'll get some student-athletes and follow him. So we'll finish it out with Jerry Carino and then Dylan McCoy from the Targa.
Steve, you played Illinois 3 months ago. Can you draw anything from that game, or is that ancient history at this point?
Yeah, I mean, it's a long time. They're very different now. I think we're different. You know, it's a long time ago, but, you know, our guys watched the tape tonight. We've already spent our time doing some things. But, you know, that game was a long time ago, and different stakes right now.
Coach, you know, both halves seem to struggle kind of slowly for both teams, you know, slow shooting, especially in the first half. Talk about how resilient this team was and, you know, how they really pulled themselves out after those first couple minutes.
Yeah, I mean, we always, you know, continue to fight. So, I mean, new gym, didn't have a shoot around, spent no time here. It is different. It's very different. But I think you saw two really good basketball teams just going back and forth, and that's what happens. You know, and sometimes you get off to good starts. Sometimes they get off to good starts. It's a 40-minute game. Just got to keep playing. And, you know, that's what we did tonight. I wasn't too worried about, you know, when they had a lead. You know, I felt really good about our guys being locked in. We had two terrific practices leading up. And the guys were playing. They were playing with their personalities. They were up and down the floor. They were enjoying a basketball game.